we go.
Hello again. I hope that at this time I find you all very well and very happy. This time out, our vision is going slightly further afield than has been normal so far, about 30 miles further afield. So, let's zoom in for a much closer look and find out where we're going. And we're going to the Magpie mine. This was Derbyshire's last working lead mine, and the only one where a considerable amount of the buildings from several eras remain substantially intact. It's to be found near Buxton, immediately to the south of a village called Sheldon. It encompasses the five original mines, the Magpie mine itself, the Dirty Red Soil mine, the Great Red Soil, the May Pit, and the Horse Steps mine. The mine is sited at the junction of the Magpie, the Butts, and the Bowl veins of lead ore. As you might expect, it has quite a story to tell. The title of Magpie Mine was first used in records relating to ore production in 1740, and the mine finally closed in 1958, but some think that it had been working for over 300 years. With boom and bust, murder and curses being the meat on the bones of this fascinating mine story, it appears to me to be a story worthy of the telling. To the east of the Magpie is a modern reproduction of a horse gin, a horse-powered winding wheel, used to raise and lower the cobs, the miners' wheelbarrows, and the cage, the lift which carried the miners and their equipment. This is sited above the closed-off shaft of the Red Soil Mine. In 1793, the mine was closed due to extensive flooding, something that would happen regularly in the coming years. The fact that originally these mines were all separate entities was the source of much rivalry, with miners disputing other miners' rights to work in the various seams. In 1833, a dispute between the Magpie and the Maypit miners led to a tragedy. Fires had been started underground by the miners from the Magpie. These fires were an attempt to smoke out some Maypit miners, who were considered to be trespassing upon their seam. It was in the end responsible for the deaths of three of the Maypit miners. Twenty-four Magpie miners were charged and put on trial, accused of the murder of the three unfortunate men. But the prosecutions failed because of conflicting evidence. No one was sure about whom exactly had been responsible. It was also deemed that the accused had been severely provoked by the victims and their colleagues in the time leading up to the offence. So, after just a year behind the bars, the only five who had been incarcerated were all released and acquitted. Outraged by what they saw as a complete failure in getting justice for their late husbands, The three widows allegedly placed a curse on the Magpie mine, which is said to never have turned a profit afterwards. There are some reports which mention the viewing of a ghost here in 1946, although exactly what took him so long to make an appearance is not mentioned. The mine closed after this in 1835, after some serious flooding reoccurred. In 1839, the mine was reopened yet again. This time, engineer John Taylor, who had built a reputation for himself in Cornwall, took charge of the mine. He modernised it from top to bottom and created a far more professional entity, which now included the other four mines from the immediate area. Interestingly, when a newer winding engine was installed in 1869, it was a case of waste not, want not, and the flue was built horizontally at ground level, connecting the new boiler house to the old square chimney. These were both restored in 2016 after receiving money from the National Lottery Fund. It was at the personal insistence of none other than John Taylor himself that steel borers, safety fuses, steel winding rope, and safety helmets were used for the first time in the mine. The square Cornish style engine house replaced an earlier engine house building in 1869, and the newer winding engine was then installed, with the winding drum that is present today. Cue Rambo again for the steep climb. Taylor's reorganisation included better management, proper rates of pay and shifts. He deepened the mine shaft and introduced a new pumping engine. The two chimneys were built in 1840, along with the agent's house and smithy, the no longer present winding house, the gunpowder house, and the engine reservoir. These were all constructed at about this time. The main shaft is almost 730 feet deep, but as it regularly flooded, a leat, sough or drain was built between 1873 and 1881 to remove the water to the River Wye, which is over a mile away, a duty which it is still performing today. This was a burden which, at a sum at the time variously reported as between £14,000 and £35,000, nearly bankrupted the owners, and the mine closed once more in 1883. The Magpie continued to function sporadically into the 20th century. It was reopened in 1913 and again in 1923, only to close once more in 1924. After the end of World War II, more modernisation was carried out in an attempt to make the mine profitable. However, in spite of all of the modernisation, insufficient amounts of lead ore were found and the mine closed yet again in 1958. This time, it was a permanent solution, and the mine fell slowly into decay and dereliction. It's considered by many to be the finest surviving remains of its type anywhere in the UK. In fact, there's a corrugated iron structure which housed the winding gear, which, although a relic of the 1950s, is one of only three corrugated iron structures in the country which are scheduled. All of this in no small way contributed to recognition of the importance of the site, which received the accolade of being a listed scheduled monument in 1974. Ah, an easier task for Rambo this time, going down. Unfortunately, all of the shafts, of which there are many, are now blocked off for safety reasons. Some of these shafts are over 500 feet deep. Luckily, this still leaves the remaining above-ground features for you to walk around and drink in the atmosphere of those bygone times. As mentioned, the building to the south of the main site is the agent's house and smithy. This has been restored and is now used as a field centre by the Peak District Mines Historical Society. If you're interested in any further information, please see the links in the description. Well, sadly that's it for this time. Please feel free to look at the other videos on my channel. If you have any ideas for future topics, then I'd love to hear from you. If you enjoyed this, or indeed any of the other offerings which I've provided, then please like and subscribe. That way, you'll be sure not to miss any of them. Also, a thumbs up on the YouTube site would be greatly appreciated, as it helps me to know what you all enjoy and lets YouTube recommend these to others. Hopefully, I'll see you here next time. Until then, have fun and stay safe.